Good morning, Pacers. My name is Isis, a junior class of 2017.
And I'm Levi, senior class of 2016.
Today is Wednesday, April 20th, and you're watching Pacers on Demand. When I die in the name of the prayers, gonna go
to the place that's the best. When I lay me down. Pacers, our open house recruitment fair is fast approaching. Just like last year, we have stages present for performances and entertainment. If you or your friends are interested in performing at this year's recruitment fair, then see Mr. J in room E10 to sign up. All types of acts are welcome, but space will fill up quickly, so sign up soon.
Hello, seniors and juniors. Are you interested in learning about the different careers in the building industry? North State Building Industry Foundation will be here on Wednesday, May 4th, 2016, to tell you all about the industry. You will hear about the different opportunities and services they provide for students. If interested, please go to sign up in the counseling office.
Congratulations to Maury Montavlo for winning the anti-smoking billboard contest at Grand High. Please go to the school's homepage and vote for Maury to advance to the next round of competition. The direct link is www.rationalsurvey.com/s/11403. Good luck to you, Maury.
Attention seniors going to prom. Joseph Neubong has a promo code to get a $40 discount on your tuxedo rental at Men's Warehouse. Use promo code 6489837. Again, that's 6489837. See you at the dance.
Hey, Pacers. Would you like to help plan all of your class events such as prom, trips, and fundraisers? Then you should run for a class officer position. Applications for class president, vice president, secretary, and treasurer are being accepted and can be picked up on main campus in room E2 with Ms. Acosta. You will have until Friday, April 22nd, 2016 to submit your application, and elections will take place Friday, May 6th.
Calling all student leaders, if you're interested in taking the student leadership class next year, please pick up an application on main campus in room E2 with Ms. Acosta. All of the students who selected to take the class when you registered for a class scheduled for next year must also apply. Space is limited. You must apply by Friday, April 22nd, 2016.
Calling all clubs, classes, and sports. Registration for the recruitment fair, as well as Fun in the Sun, can be found in E2 with Ms. Acosta. Recruitment forms must be submitted by Friday, April 22nd. Fun in the Sun forms must be submitted by Monday, May 2nd.
Attention Pacers, has a staff member at Grant made an impact on you? Take the time to write a thank you note to them. CSF is sponsoring the Grant Most Valuable Pacers program, where you can write a note to say thanks to a teacher or staff member here at Grant. If there's someone you want to say thank you to, find the link on your school loop email sent by Ms. Bittler or on the front page of the school website. The website will be available from now until April 27th. The thank you notes will be compiled into booklets and given to staff members on May 3rd. Take a minute and let those who help you know that you appreciate them.
Hey, freshmen. The next assembly for those with GPAs of 3.0 or higher will be held in May. Don't forget to raise your grades if you want to be part of it.
Hey, guys. My name is Ralph, and I'm here about to go get information about the Miranda rights. Let's go. Hi, I'm here with...
Officer Eric Fong, Second Police Department.
What are the Miranda rights?
The Miranda rights were a case back in about 1963. There's a man, Mr. Miranda versus Arizona, and it gives people the rights, not basically self-incriminating. So a lot of us carry these Miranda cards with us. And it has all the Miranda rights here. So you have the right to remain silent, do you understand? So we always want to make sure that the suspect, the subject, understands their rights. So we ask them, do you have the right to remain silent? Do you understand? They say yes. If they say yes, and I ask the next question, any you say maybe be used against you in court, do you understand that? I say yes, then I go to the next question, do you have the right to the presence of an attorney before and during questioning? And they say yes, and then we move on to the next question. The fourth question is, if you cannot afford an attorney, we'll be appointed you free of charge before any questioning. Do you understand that? So basically, if someone understands those four, their four Miranda rights, then I can ask them questions about a crime, like, did you shoot the person? Where did you hide the drugs? How many times did you stab the person? If I don't give them their Miranda rights, and they tell me information about the crime that could be incriminating them, then I can't use that in court. So it's very important for us, if we're going to question or interrogate a suspect, that we have to bring the Miranda rights. And it's for everybody, not just adults, but also for juveniles. For juveniles, we actually have to Mirandize them as quickly as possible or as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. So once the safe is seen, I have to Mirandize juveniles. That's an extra precaution we have for juveniles.
Should schools teach the Miranda rights to the students?
I think so. It's a part of the Constitution. And I think that everyone should know their rights, again, especially juveniles, that you have these rights given to you by the Constitution and by case law. So it's very important that you guys understand those things.
All right. What is the history between the Miranda rights, and can they be used against you?
Well, like I said before, if I asked somebody, but I arrested somebody, and I think that he shot somebody, and I start asking the questions before I Mirandize him, any information he gives me, I can't use in court. It's basically a false or illegal statement. So once I Mirandize a person, and whatever he tells me, I can testify in court. And that all goes in the report, and that goes for the record. So that's basically our evidence. So this is basically like a confession. So if he goes, I never said that in court, I will go testify and say, I Mirandize, you know, suspect John Doe. He told me A, B, C, and D, and that he is the one that shot this person. The court and the jury will listen to me and take that into as evidence.
Well, guys, it has been a fun experience learning about the Miranda rights. My name is Ralph. Have a great day.
Well, this concludes your morning announcement.
Pacers On Demand was brought to you by the Grant Student Programming Network and...
On behalf of the Arts Academy.
My name is Isis.
And I'm Levi.
Have a wonderful day, Pacers.